awesome Kasturi Dohra. I saw a bit of the show. She's driven, she's smart, and she's also an inspiration. So when you did take on this character, how do you think this particular character will inspire women across, and how important was it for you to play this character?
First and foremost, very good evening to all of you present here. आप सबका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद कि समय निकाल के आप यहाँ आए हैं हमारे लिए, तो उसके लिए थैंक यू सो मच एंड थैंक यू फॉर सच काइंड वर्ड्स पूजा. इनका इंट्रोडक्शन ऑलवेज धमाकेदार रहता है तो उसमें भी एक अपने आप में जोश आ जाता है, सो थैंक यू फॉर दैट. आप लोग देखेंगे अभी आगे ही एपिसोड भी देखेंगे एंड आई थिंक जहाँ तक के कस्तूरी डोगरा है एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग एज अ पर्सन, जैसे कि इन्होंने कैरेक्टर का इंट्रोडक्शन दिया ही, शी इज फियर्स, शी इज इंडिपेंडेंट एंड शी इज अ ब्रिलियंट कॉप. शी इज अ पुलिस वाली फ्रॉम हेड टू टो एंड किस तरीके से वो अपने लाइफ, अपने पर्सनल लाइफ को भी बैलेंस करती है, घर गृहस्थी भी संभालती है एंड शी इज आउट देयर इन द फील्ड, मेहनत कर रही है, डबल मेहनत कर रही है. एंड जो मैं समझती हूँ हमारी जितनी औरतें हैं उनके ऊपर ऑलवेज घर गृहस्थी संभालने की भी ओनस होती है एंड एट द सेम टाइम दे वॉन्ट टू एक्सेल इन द फील्ड, इन देयर चोजन पाथ, जो उनका ड्रीम जॉब है उसमें भी वो अचीव करना चाहती हैं. तो उनके लिए एक ये हमारी तरफ से एक छोटा सा कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है, एक छोटा सा मैसेज भी है फैमिलीज को. जितनी हमारी विमेन इन यूनिफॉर्म है, जितनी जिस भी जॉब सेक्टर में है, हमारी कितनी अभी फीमेल जर्नलिस्ट भी हैं यहाँ पे और काम करना चाहती हैं, प्रमोशन लेना चाहती हैं, लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं वो बैलेंस करने में उनकी हालतें खराब हो जाती हैं. तो मैं उनके घर वालों को हम ये मैसेज देना चाहते हैं कि बी द विंड बीनीथ हर विंग्स, उनको सपोर्ट दो, उनको इमोशनल सपोर्ट दो. वो तो अपने बच्चों और अपने हस्बैंड के ड्रीम्स अचीव करने में कोई एक नहीं छोड़ती हैं, तो आप भी यू मस्ट बी द हेल्प, अ हाउस होल्ड हेल्प, लेंड अ हेल्पिंग हैंड सो दैट शी ऑल्सो एक्सेल्स एंड कैन ड्रीम एंड कम्प्लीट हर ड्रीम फॉर वॉट एवर वर्क शी इज एंड वॉट शी वॉन्ट्स टू अचीव. सो हियर अबाउट इज वॉट where the script completely touched me, Kasturi Dohra's role, and here I am, and there I will be.
And before I go on to Monica, because Netflix has been giving us such content, I want to ask you, Raveena, how do you think these roles have evolved over the years in the industry, and also as a, you know, lead actor?
I think, like I tell everybody, that one can see a great positive change happening. Thanks to even the OTT platforms that have come in, and even if you see a lineup of Netflix, they have these really strong, power-driven female characters, shows made on them. And even in our industry, I think the change, the evolution, probably of giving our women, you know, stronger roles and greater opportunities, had already started. So if you saw when Alia Bhatt made her debut, when Deepika made her debut, in the first two films, they were probably just fresh. What we did in probably our 15th or 16th film, these girls started delivering in their second or third film, whether it was a Highway or it was a Baji Rao or it was Padmavat or it was anything. They were just completely fantastic and they got those kind of strong roles. So the evolution definitely had started. Women were getting greater opportunities and like I say again, here I am.
And we are glad to have you here. And Monica, now coming to you. Netflix has had this amazing slate, and especially in the past couple of years where, you know, where stories about women, untold stories, you know, that you've presented them. So tell us a bit about your commitment in bringing these stories from, you know, basically paper to screen and real life stories onto reel.
Thanks, Pooja, and thank you everyone for really, like Raveena said, taking out your precious time and coming here. We are so excited to bring Aranya to all of you. Where stories are concerned, Pooja, honestly, when we look at how the evolution of storytelling has been, cinema has been, or any medium for that matter, we often forget, you know, barring television, we often forget that women make 50% of this world. But we don't have enough representation of women in stories. And honestly, most of the time when you see the characters, the women are either represented as weak or dependent or needing assistance or, you know, being in a support or helpful sort of a role. It, like Raveena said, it has been changing over the years, but not perhaps fast enough. But I think what streaming has done And what particularly from a Netflix point of view, I can say our commitment to representing women in storytelling is really, a very deep commitment, a very continued and consistent commitment that we have, which is why a character like Kasturi Dogra, we were so fascinated when Sid and Rohan and Vinay shared the script with us, Charu, who's the writer, the character of Kasturi really demonstrates to you, and you'll see that, she's the same soft-hearted, she's a mother, she's a wife, she's a lovely daughter-in-law, but she's also a tough cop. And the way she is as a cop, she knows that, she has waited for opportunities to come her way. And when she has that moral dilemma, that should she really, what should she do? Should she take this case or should she, go back to her family? And even though she's been doing everything for her family, you realize that she is an example where she tries to manage both, and she does in her own beautiful way. And I think that is what women characters need to do. That is what they do in our stories. In our team at Netflix also, I should tell you, we are 50% of women executives at Netflix globally. We are 50% in our leadership teams. And last year, Pooja, we worked with more than 1,000 women cast, crew, creators. We had wonderful stories like Bombay Begums. We had Paglet. We had Masaba. We have so many. In half of our films and series, we try to have women characters, because really the world will be a better place if we have equal and fair representation, and we want to break the gender stereotypes and really entertain all of you with all perspectives and aspects of storytelling.
Absolutely, which you are, and we just can't seem to get enough of Netflix and the content that you give us. And now coming to the captain of this ship, Vinay. Now, crime thrillers are very popular, but it's also a very tricky genre. So when you are helming a project like this, how do you decide what goes into it? How do you work around it to keep the audience interested? Because you have to continuously keep giving cliffhangers, and it's just a lot of hard work and mental work as well.
Yeah, that's right. Crime thrillers are always interesting, but tricky. And it has been my favorite genre as well. So thanks to Aranyak, thanks to Netflix, thanks to Rohan and Sid, that got a chance to direct one. For me, crime thrillers are like, and especially series, is like, one of those, Arabian Nights stories, where, the Sherezade has to give so much, but still hold back the interest so that she doesn't get killed. So it's like, for me, it's that, after every episode, basically I give enough to the audience, but still hold back enough so that for the next episode, those are the cliffhangers basically. But yeah, it has been a great journey. 2 years for me, for Rohan and Sid, much more than that. But it's been great during pandemic doing this, we are really lucky to be in the mountains. Thank you.
I could see that from the little that I've seen. It's very, very promising. And aap mein se kitne log Aranyak ka meaning jante ho? Agar hum Rohan se poochte hain, how did that name come about? And a little bit about this project. So how did this come about?
Thank you again, everyone, for being here. Well, the name is ek jungle vasi ko Aranyak manenge. And I think Vinay is the one who actually suggested that after we were into the project, but it had the right feel, the mystery we wanted to convey, and the writer Charu is a collaborator I worked with for a long time. He's actually been to IFFI for many, many years probably. It's a great circle for him also to finally have his work premiering at IFFI. He's been in the audience here over decades. So when he basically told me about this true character he met on a holiday in Himachal, a female police officer. She sounded so fascinating and so full of life that he said, if you're going to do, we love the genre of the detective shows, but we have to make it Indian. We have to really make it connect. And when he started telling me about this, I knew he had the germ of something special here. Because it's grown out from there. Like Vinay said, we've overcome many things, but it's so much gratitude I felt even while we were shooting, just as the pandemic was easing, just the privilege of being in one of God's most beautiful places, and being able to work and put something like this together, and of course at the heart of it, you know, wonderful actors headlined by Raveena. So, I mean, I was studying in college when Raveena acted in a film, Patthar Ki Phool, and I met her then. I'm so happy that 30 years later we're still working together, and hopefully there's 30 more to come, you know, as platforms like Netflix give us the chance to tell these stories, you know. So I think that's it's really all around. It's been wonderful collaborating with Sid, Vinay, all the team. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed the journey that we'll be taking you through on this, and it's really been a privilege to be part of it.
Thank you so much. And as you said, 30 years later, Raveena will still look the same. So now coming to you, Siddharth. What makes you decide about taking on a project? Is it the cast? Is it the story? And do you feel that this project has the potential to have your name to it? And what was it about Aranyak that you decided to back it?
So, you know, when Rohan and Charu came to us with the story, like Rohan said, it grips you immediately. And it came from a personal experience that Charu had actually interacting with a female cop of this nature when he made a trip to a hill station. And the way that he was able to bring her personality to life with the anecdote that he, you know, told us, and then the story that Rohan and he had actually built around that was so compelling and so unique. And like Rohan said, they managed to take the, you know, the our sort of collective fascination with crime thrillers from the West and Indianize it in a way that made it so organic and authentic. So, you know, it was an instinctive reaction. It was a gut reaction to say, this sounds like something very compelling that we would love to be associated with as well. And then, of course, when it came into casting, as I said, you know, Raveena was the first person that we approached because we really wanted it to be unique in every way. And the fact that she had held back from doing anything on the digital medium was great because we really felt that this would be a, you know, wonderful thing for her to be doing as her first thing that she's doing in the digital medium. And thankfully, she felt the same. So it was great to have that happen. And then when Netflix and Vinay came on board as well, you know, it was like, you know, we started the journey and then everyone joined in, and it was all the right collaborators getting together. So that doesn't happen very often. It is serendipitous and really nice when it happens in a creative enterprise because you don't always have that experience. And it does feel special that we were able to do this project under pretty trying, you know, circumstances.
Absolutely.
Those first few days with everyone literally in PPE kits was like you were on the set of like an outbreak had occurred.
True.
Or something like that. Then of course it eased up. But very, very excited. And just one more thing I want to say personally is that I grew up watching, you know, Sholay once every month. And therefore to have the Roy Kapoor Films company associated with Ramesh Sippy Entertainment, someone that I've looked up to that much, is really quite incredible.
Sure, and I can tell you that this series has also blockbuster written on it. So I'm now going to ask Monica, what is it about Aranyak that excites you? And what draws Netflix, your platform, to stories like these?
Netflix has done a lot of crime stories, and crime thriller as a genre is one of the most watched genre on Netflix. We have some of the finest stories there made by the world's best creators. But crime noir as a space, as a genre, is not that well explored in India. Even in cinema, if we see, very few stories have really, been really stellar in terms of the way the characters are, the way the story has been put together. And in a series format, I don't think such a series has happened in the crime noir space. So I think this was the first of its kind, and we were very, very keen to bring something extremely authentic in this space, something that we are known for globally. And what would be that journey of finding a story of these very authentic, rooted characters in a small Himalayan town, you know, who are living their lives, and you can relate to their troubles, their trials, and also, you know, the choices that they make, the greed that some of them have, you know, and how they are living about their daily lives, and yet how tourists come and become a part of their life and create drama in their lives, which probably, you know, they are seeking at some level and they are hating at some level. because it brings complications in their lives. So I think that all those layers in the story, the way each character, is etched out, an outsider coming in, the chemistry of those people. So I think as the script was shared with us, and I can't resist saying this, when Rohan and Sid said, Charu, our writer, he has this ability of meeting people and then, writing them as characters into his show. So like he met this cop. He really writes on his Facebook about this fisherwoman he meets in the... So who knows, next could be a story around that. So so I think that's the authenticity of it. Really attracted us, the strength of the characters, Kasturi, even Angad's character, Manhas, the local politicians, every single character, sort of...
It's important the one who's paying my husband.
Huh? Oh, yes, Hari. Yes, how can I forget Kasturi's husband, Hari, and their children, and and the father-in-law, played by Ashutosh Rana. It's really a very... It's a wonderful ensemble cast, and we are so proud to have all of them on Netflix telling this story. And I really hope you all like the authentic crime noir Netflix style.
I'm sure they will. And coming to Kasturi Dobra, that's Ravina. Ravina, you've played several intense characters in the past, whether it was in Daman, where you were a victim of domestic abuse. There was Satta, now you're playing Kasturi Dobra. How do you sink your teeth and get into the mindset of a character that has absolutely grown up with a different set of beliefs than you have? So what's the process that goes in, and how can you separate the two? You know, sometimes as an actor, you get into that mind space.
Actually, kehne ko jaau to jahan tak ki Kasturi aur main as characters hain, zyada we are not very, very different. Lekin, जहाँ तक के कस्तूरी से रिलेट करना, दैट कम्स इजी बिकॉज यू सी सो मेनी वुमेन गोइंग थ्रू दैट, वेदर दे आर योर फ्रेंड्स इन करियर स्पेसेस और इन ऑफिसेस और इवन आर वुमेन इन यूनिफॉर्म गोइंग थ्रू दैट एंटायर टर्मोइल एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ व्हाट शुड बी एक्चुअली देयर फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी, एंड दे आर रशिंग एंड बर्निंग द कैंडल मीर एट बोथ द एंड्स एंड ट्राइंग टू बी अ ग्रेट वाइफ, ग्रेट डॉटर, ग्रेट डॉटर इन लॉ, great mother, and trying to also achieve equally, working equally hard as a male counterpart, but sometimes having to sacrifice opportunities, great opportunities that come their way, because probably at that point their family needs them. And like I said, the onus also about anything that happens or goes right or wrong in the household is also falls onto the woman of the house. So for me, I felt Kasturi Dobra. Maybe I did not identify with her because, like I said, a lot of us probably come from lucky, privileged families where our families have given us the backing support that we need to achieve and excel in our jobs. But there are so many women out there who probably hear sarcastic comments coming in from their family. अरे तुम्हें तो फैमिली की पड़ी नहीं है, घर में खाना क्या बन रहा है, तुम जानती भी हो, तुम तो सिर्फ ऑफिस में लगी हुई हो. Then they reach the office and the boss says, please don't play the victim motherhood card on me, that typical woman card on me. Everyone has a job and everyone has families. So it's a situation that a lot of women find themselves, absolutely being torn apart.
Absolutely. And you should watch on December 10th what she has done, and you will be mighty impressed. And now Rohan, coming to you. Now this has several characters and it's like an onion, one layer after the other. As I said, everyone is a suspect here. So how do you keep that mystery going? Because there are several characters and each one has his or her own arc.
Well, again, of course, this is largely a credit to Charu, but he designed it so well, where you can play with the ambiguity of the characters. I mean, like you said, and then we were lucky enough to get an incredible cast. Mahadev Dogra, Kasturi's father-in-law, played by Ashutosh Rana, is probably one of my favorite characters in the show. He and Kasturi have almost like a father-son relationship, and his own son is almost like the way a conventional daughter-in-law would be treated. So just the way so whether it's the suspects, whether it's just the human side of things, and of course then there's Zakir Hussain playing this politician, opposite him is Meghna Malik. So you realize they're playing at multiple levels. So I think what, again, long form storytelling like a show with 300-350 minutes allows you to do is let these characters and these actors have that room to explore, and the director to be able to let us enjoy and start reading into, is there something more to what he's saying? I mean, in a film you can't do that, you know, in a film it's in 2 hours, but when you have this time, you can really take advantage of it. And I think on the writing, on the execution, they've done an amazing job, and of course the performances will hopefully keep you wondering, and then you'll circle back and say, wait, did I miss something? And I think that really gets driven by the primary emotion of it, which I think for me is the thing I connected most to, this idea of Kasturi. You know, you wait your whole life for an opportunity and then you think it might pass you by, and then that chance for redemption is something hopefully that will also be something that people will connect to and will help them go through the whodunit part of it. So it's not just trying to outguess the makers. I think it's really about feeling their personal lives get more and more involved as the series goes on. So I think, yeah, Charu's done a great job of bringing these layers in, and the team has then put them all together beautifully.
Coming to you, I know you said you give a little and then you pull back, but there are multiple episodes. How do you keep their attention going that you wait for the next episode?
I mean, that's a tricky one. You'll have to watch and say if I have done it successfully.
That's true.
But, you know, it's like a game of chess which you are playing, and you are, both the players are played by you only. So, you know, you make a move, then they go on the other side, and how much of that you have got as an audience. So you'll have to keep them engaged. You'll have to keep giving enough so that they don't leave the game and just go. So that, you know, all, like, you know, they are there till the end with you. But you still can't allow them to go ahead of the story as well, you know. So it's not just like while directing. It's like, you know, collaborating with the DP, collaborating with the background music guys, sound, actors, you know. It's like you'll have to find that. It's a space, is very narrow space. Now, it's a very tightrope walk. If you give little more than that, they will guess what it is. And if you don't give them enough, then they'll be like, okay, I'm not following you. I don't want to be here. So, yeah, it's interesting. But, and it's very, very mentally engaging for me as well to go through that process. But, yeah, it's been fun. Arunak has been fun.
Yeah, we are waiting to watch that. And now coming to you, Siddharth, over the last couple of years, we've seen the industry evolve in terms of formats and platforms. What kind of freedom does it give to creators like you? And where do you see this going, though?
I think it truly is the golden age, in a sense, for content creators right now. Because, you know, it's all additive. When people talk about theatrical versus streaming, it's the same way they used to talk about satellite television versus theatrical in the past. It really doesn't have to be mutually exclusive at all. All platforms can coexist. I think we all know from all our lives that we want to be able to watch content in different ways on different platforms. At times, we want to be able to have more control over our viewing experience. At times, we want to have a cinematic experience. So I think for content creators, it's a wonderful time, because today you can tell all kinds of stories, and really the story will find the platform that is most apt for it. And I think that, I really think that content, I guess platforms like Netflix, what they've done for us is to be able to have our content viewed across the world in so many countries simultaneously was something that was a filmmaker's dream, right? We were held back by distribution in the past. We were not able to go out to so many countries. We knew that it would be a diaspora release, it would be apologetic, there'd be 4 prints in 1 market in Latin America. You don't even know if the film will be getting the chance that it can have. But today, there aren't any excuses. Now it's all on us. Now that content is out there. It's viewed in more than 190 countries around the world, day and date. So now the challenge is back to us about, are we going to be able to tell stories that actually are able to cross continents? Number one, we have to cross states within our own country. Then we've got to cross countries, then we want to cross continents. So I think content creators, writers, directors, actors, we should all take it as a challenge upon ourselves now to be able to create content that resonates regardless of the platform that it's on.
Absolutely. And as I wrap up, would like to ask this entire team, what do they think that, you know, all of you can expect from Aranyak? So Ravina, first to you, what do you think the audience is going to take back once they watch the show?
their mobile phones for sure. कोई पीछे छोड़ के नहीं जाने वाला. हाँ जी. बंधीर चलो ठीक है. I think when I will be actually watching the first episode with them as well. I haven't seen it in its entirety.
Oh, wow.
So I'm as excited probably that I'll be watching it along with all of you for the first time. All I can say is that, you know, we've really worked hard on this. It's been a labor of love from everyone sitting on this podium. It's been a pleasure working with this team, and I'm really honored that you know, I've had the chance to work with Sid and Vinayji and Monica and Rohan again. So it has been, and our entire ensemble, eclectic cast that we have, everyone's excelled at whatever they have got to do in our series. So the hard work is there to show under extreme, you know, weather conditions through the pandemic, taking safety precautions all the time and so strictly that luckily we didn't have even one incident on our set. And we were so careful throughout. I'm hoping we continue being careful as I'm wearing my mask, which most of you aren't. मुझे 14 दिन की छुट्टी चाहिए ही नहीं. So the just like I said, I'm as excited as you all. And I think what the audience will definitely take away is Kasturi Dogra's character, because I fell in love with her when I read her. We'll love Ashutosh's character. He is playing Mahadev Dogra. Completely love him. You will love Hari, who's probably a hero. Yeah, who you love to hate, but you will end up loving him as well. You love Angad Singh, that is Param. So all I'm hoping is for all of you to take back is to continue being in love with us and give us your blessings and all your good wishes, and that's all what I'm expecting. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So now, and before I ask Monica to give her, okay, I thought that somebody was wanting to ask a question there. Rohan and Vinay and Siddharth, what do you think they will take back from Aranyak?
I hope it just really engages and entertains them. That's really the idea behind the show. The idea is for you to be entertained, and we do hope you are. We work very hard to make that happen.
Yes, as Sid said, engagement and entertainment is something which we are sure, and we are pretty confident that you will love it. You will give all the love which Arundhak deserves, and really waiting to get your feedback and reactions.
I just hope you guys now circle December 10th after this episode, that's all, and watch the rest of it, first day, first show, as they say. Yeah.
Thank you so much, and thank you all of you. And Monica, could you share a few words with the audience here? What can they take back, and what would you want to tell them, or what lies ahead on Netflix?
Actually, I think if I was sitting in the audience, I would just be eager that all of us should just shut up now and show you the show.